today's topic, rational root theorem. Example, find the roots of f of x is equal to x cubed minus 4x squared plus x plus 6. Step 1, find the factors of the constant term and the leading coefficient. The constant term is 6. The factors of 6 are positive and negative 1, positive and negative 2, positive and negative 3, and positive and negative 6. The leading coefficient is the numerical coefficient of the leading term, or the term with the highest power. The leading term here is x cubed. It is the term with the highest power. The coefficient of x cubed is understood to be 1. The factors of 1 are positive and negative 1. Step number 2. Find the possible rational roots. Divide the factors of 6 by the factors of 1. That is, divide the factors of the constant term by the factors of the leading coefficient. So, positive and negative 1 divided by positive and negative 1 is equal to positive and negative 1. Positive and negative 2 divided by positive and negative 1 is equal to positive and negative 2. Positive and negative 3 divided by positive and negative 1 is equal to positive and negative 3. And positive and negative 6 divided by positive and negative 1 is equal to positive and negative 6. The possible rational roots are positive and negative 1, positive and negative 2, positive and negative 3, and positive and negative 6. These are the possible rational roots: positive and negative 1, positive and negative 2, positive and negative 3, and positive and negative 6. Step number 3. Try its possible rational roots. Apply the factor theorem. The factor theorem is stated as, if f of x is a polynomial, then x minus c is a factor of f of x if f of c is equal to 0. Trial number 1. F of x is equal to x cubed minus 4x squared plus x plus 6. Let us try positive 1. Replace x with positive 1. So we have f of 1. Replace x with positive 1. So we have 1 cubed. Replace x with positive 1. So we have minus 4 times 1 squared. Replace x with positive 1 plus 1 plus 6. We have now f of 1 is equal to 1. 1 because if you multiply 1 by itself 3 times, you get 1. If you multiply 1 by itself twice and multiply the result by negative 4, you get minus 4. Then plus 1 plus 6. 1 minus 4 plus 1 plus 6 is equal to 4. So f of 1 is equal to 4. We write no, because 1 is not a root of the function. f of 1 is not equal to 0. Again, these are the possible rational roots we obtain. Positive and negative 1, positive and negative 2, positive and negative 3, and positive and negative 6. Trial number 2. F of x is equal to x cubed minus 4x squared plus x plus 6. This time, we are going to try negative 1. Replace x with negative 1. So we have f of negative 1 is equal to, replace x with negative 1. Open parenthesis, negative 1, close parenthesis, cube. And then replace x with negative 1. So we have minus 4, open parenthesis, negative 1, close parenthesis, squared. Replace x with negative 1. So minus 1 and then plus 6. We have now f of negative 1 is equal to, if you multiply negative 1 by itself 3 times, you will get negative 1. If you multiply negative 1 by itself twice, it becomes positive 1, and then you multiply positive 1 by negative 4, you get negative 4 minus 1 plus 6. Negative 1, negative 4, negative 1, positive 6 is equal to 0. So f of negative 1 is equal to 0. We write yes. That means negative 1 is a root of the polynomial function. So we write x is equal to negative 1. We found out that negative 1 is a root of the function. The next thing to do is to use synthetic division. Copy the numerical coefficients, omit the variables and the exponents. So we have 1, negative 4, positive 1, positive 6. 1 because the numerical coefficients of x cubed is understood to be 1. Positive 1 because the numerical coefficient of x is understood to be positive 1. Write negative 1 to the left of 1. Draw a line. Copy 1 and write it below the line. Multiply 1 by negative 1. Negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. Write negative 1 below negative 4. Then add. Negative 4 plus negative 1 is negative 5. Multiply negative 5 by negative 1. Negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5. Write positive 5 below positive 1. Then add. Positive 1 plus positive 5 is positive 6. Multiply positive 6 by negative 1. Negative 1 times positive 6 is negative 6. Write negative 6 below positive 6, then add. Positive 6 plus negative 6 is equal to 0. 0 is the remainder. This means that negative 1 is really a root of the function. The first three numbers here are the numerical coefficients of x squared minus 5x plus 6. 2 because 3 minus 1 is 2. It is understood the exponent here is 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. It is understood this is 6 times x raised to 0. The exponent here is understood to be 1. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. This is a quadratic trinomial equated to 0. And it is a monic quadratic trinomial. Let us factor x squared minus 5x plus 6. Factor 6 into 2 factors such that when you add the 2 factors, the sum is equal to the numerical coefficient of the middle term. 6. Let us try 2 and 3. 2 times 3 is 6. 2 plus 3 is 5 or positive 5, but positive 5 is different from negative 5. So let us try another factors. So negative 2 and then negative 3. Negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6. Negative 2 plus negative 3 is negative 5. So we choose negative 2 and negative 3. Draw two parentheses, each beginning with x. Write negative 2 after the first x and negative 3 after the second x. These are the factors of x squared minus 5x plus 6. Next, equate the factors to 0. X minus 2 is equal to 0, or x minus 3 is equal to 0. Transpose negative 2 to the other side. Change its sign from negative to positive. So we have x is equal to 2. Transpose negative 3 to the other side. Change its sign from negative to positive. So we have x is equal to 3. Therefore, the roots of the polynomial function are negative 1, 2, and 3.